Welcome back to Google Developers Weekly for September 23rd, 2013. I'm Lewis Gray, and this is our highlight reel of what's happening in the world of Google developers, on the set and off. Strap in, buckle up. We've got a lot to talk about. First, beautiful code and intelligent applications often lead to happy users. But if an application or a website confuses a user, it introduces friction and it can stop your startup cold. Nazmul Idris, a champion for user experience, stopped by Root Access with host Don Dodge to teach us how to reduce friction and boost user acquisition. As you can imagine, here at Team GDL, we believe strongly in the power of YouTube subscriptions. From New York, Ibrahim Ulukaya and Kurt Wilms walked us through how to code and customize the recently launched subscribe button, bringing your videos to those users who don't want to miss a single minute of your content. We then saw the Google Analytics duo of Andrew Wales and Neil Rhodes introduce us to Google Tag Manager for Android and iOS, making it easier to update website data and mobile apps to measure traffic and user behavior to make your products even better. And in a new feature here on GDL, we invited the Google Enterprise Maps team for the first episode of What in the World? Dylan and Ryan Thomas, who I assume are not related, showed us how to access Google Maps engine layers using Maps API JavaScript. Keep in mind, this replaces the map data layer for those of you who are GDO coders. Looking at my map, it turns out our next GDL came from the Southern Hemisphere from Buenos Aires, where Nick Bortolotti returned with the latest from Latin America, talking Chrome browser extensions. Todo es bueno, ¿verdad? And before the week wrapped, Don Dodge was back for round two of Root Access in our studio, explaining the many variables behind startup stock ownership and what founders, investors, and employees should expect when they open the envelopes containing their options packages. This is something you have to get right to keep your employee morale high. In addition to all these great shows, we were invited to live stream from SFHTML5, the world's largest HTML5 user group, featuring many faces that you recognize from GDL, including Colt McCandless, Paul Lewis, Paul Irish, and Jake Archibald. The 2+ hour event featured 4 fantastic talks covering web performance, and we've got it all saved for you here on YouTube. So cancel your plans tonight, you've got homework. And from Italy, Claudio De Angelis talked to us about Dart. Claudio discussed how to take advantage of Dart when using model-driven views and web components to build your apps. Very nice. So as you can see, we've been hard at work sharing the latest from all around Google this week. The same is true from our friends at Android, who dropped 5 brand new Dev Bytes episodes for you mobile developers, and the latest in the Game On series, featuring Google Games Chat's own Todd Kerpelman. So find all of those and more at the Android Developers YouTube channel and at developers.google.com/live/Android. Outside the studio, you saw the demo at Google I.O., and now you can read the docs and implement it yourself. The Instant Buy API for Android makes it incredibly easy for your customers to buy an item and check out as easily as they were using the Google Play Store. No manual entry of billing or shipping info means happier customers. The Chrome team has added to its collection of dashboards with the new CSS metrics chart. Using anonymous opt-in stats from Chrome, the new dashboard shows how many pages were visited by users using each of 435 CSS properties. You can see which properties have been used or look at a usage timeline of one particular property. Take a look and watch for more dashing dashboards for Chrome usage coming in the future. Heading back into the cloud, this week BigQuery added nifty new features. You can now analyze data in real time by using the tabledata.insertall call, very useful when you need to know what's going on right away. BigQuery also added table decorators, which are not pretty centerpieces, but a syntax for enabling you to query only a subset of the newest data instead of the full table. And finally, we added a bunch of new functions and new web UI features. Also, a big change for AdSense developers this week. AdSense now provides ad code that works with HTTPS. This is more important than ever now that browsers are getting more aggressive about warning or even blocking pages with mixed secure and standard content. By using the new code in either synchronous or asynchronous flavors, you can ensure that your pages won't suffer this indignity. And to make sure you don't suffer the indignity of missing a single thing from the world of Google developers, subscribe to Google Developers on YouTube and check out the GDL schedule at developers.google.com/live. I'm Lewis Gray, and I'll see you back in the studio.